With Indiana grown, and not specifically one Indiana grown spot, restaurant, grower, but Indiana grown herself. Heather Tallman is here.
Hello.
Gets to showcase something fantastic that you guys are doing that is new.
Yes. You know, it's our 5-year anniversary this year.
Awesome.
And so we're trying to think of ways to be different and new and get our members out there. And one way is with maps and trails.
Okay.
Consumers love for you to hand them a map and say, this weekend when you don't have anything to do, go here and then go here.
A destination. Take a tour, tasting tour in particular.
Yes. So we first, about 2 years ago, actually, we launched our wine trail.
Which has done very well.
Really
when we've
had
wineries in here, they've said we love being on the wine trail because people come, they want to check it off their list and then experience what's there.
It's nice. When we first started, we had about 30 wineries and we gave them maps. We gave them stickers so they can put them on the door. We said, just stamp the map when it comes in, very easy.
Mm-hmm.
And so we quickly grew to the largest wine trail in the Midwest because,
fantastic,
again, people like trails.
And wine.
And wine. And Indiana wine. And it's a great way to get the consumers in there because that's agriculture.
Right.
And so we want them to remember that those are grapes grown and making wine and you can buy it and it all works together. And so we thought, well, we have breweries. Why not have a brewery map?
And they're growing. You've got more and more every year, every month, it seems like.
So many. So we launched, 2 weeks ago, we launched our brewery trail,
okay,
which is fun because you can go online and you can print it, or you go to the breweries and they have a copy of the map.
Nice.
There's no time limit on here, so you don't have to try to do it all in a month or a weekend.
Right.
Because we have 21 sites that you can visit.
And is that just in Indianapolis, Central Indiana, or the entire state?
The entire state.
Okay.
So we have breweries from Angola to New Albany, to Seymour, obviously Indianapolis is well covered as well.
Mm-hmm.
So if someone is an Indiana grown member and they have a place you can visit, they can be on the trail.
Fantastic.
It's open to everyone.
They're like, hey, I want to be a part of that.
Oh, yeah. Well, it's pretty easy. And people come in and they want their map stamped, of course.
Right.
It's fun. But also, they're going to sample. They're probably going to buy.
Yeah.
It's a great time to share your agriculture story from, I don't know, field to can, field to bottle.
Well, and it starts a conversation, too, about the industries that are in Indiana and then, of course, what Hoosier business owners can offer, because these small businesses do well when they're supported by their local community. So that's the brewery trail, which we're looking at, of course, some of that right up here, showcasing.
And so in the second segment, I'm going to talk a little bit about a fun trail that we released this week.
So
we
thought it was kind of fun. Not one, but two trails.
Not one, but true. But something kind of fun. We get asked pretty often about where people can buy meat directly. So you've had a lot of people on Saturdays that sell, you know, beef and chicken
and bison.
And it's kind of neat. But we have people that say, I want to buy meat in my area direct from the farmer.
Mm-hmm.
And so we created a protein guide, which has all of our members, county by county, who sell a protein, you know, goat or chicken or what have you, direct consumer. And so that has also been very popular because people want to buy this as gifts, or they want to know what farmers they can buy in their area. And at the end of the day, that's the heart of our mission.
Well, and they want to make that relationship too, trusting a farmer and being able to stay connected and then make that person their supplier for whatever meat needs they have.
Yeah.
That's great.
Yeah. And so I think reminding people that your can of beer that you enjoy or your glass of beer or whatever comes from a farm. So whether they're getting hops from Indiana, because there are hop farmers in Indiana, several of them, who are raising hops for these breweries, and they're not making that connection and talking about it. And that's kind of a neat thing to be able to show consumers.
And we're happy to get to showcase that on Wish TV too, of course. All local, all morning. We'll put this on wishtv.com and let folks know how to get a hold of this map. You saw it on your screen, but you're going to want to get a hold of this and find out where you need to go. And then in the next segment, we want to talk about trail number two.
Absolutely.